Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Kristen Carosa. Breaking news, investigators have just released new details about the suspect in the murder of four people found in barrels in Allenstown in 1985 and 2000 and the disappearance of Denise Bowden from Manchester in 1981. During his time here in New Hampshire, he was known as Bob Evans, but his true identity is Terry Peter Rasmussen. Investigators have recently learned Mr. Rasmussen was arrested by the Phoenix, Arizona police on June 11, 1975 for aggravated assault. This is his mugshot from when he was arrested on April 30th, 1973 in Phoenix as a fugitive from justice. The related charge is not clear. Because of these new details, investigators now believe it was the end of 1975 or early 1976 when he unexpectedly visited his wife and children in Payson, Arizona. Police are still trying to identify the woman with him at that time. They believe she might be the mother of his daughter, who was one of the four bodies found in Allenstown. Power crews continue to work around the clock to restore service to tens of thousands of customers still in the dark. Right now, there are just under 30,000 homes and businesses without power. There are still a few towns where more than half of the customers are without power.
We anticipate that this will be mostly wrapped up by Friday morning. Some of the challenges are just the extent of the damage, and we have hundreds of broken poles, which it really takes time to replace the pole, replace the transformer, and pull the wires. So it's a time-intensive process.
Officials have started the process of assessing all the storm in order to determine what financial aid and compensation may be available. FEMA could arrive in New Hampshire as early as next week. As people are waiting for their lights to come back on, a new warning from New Market Police, it's time to chain up your generator. WMUR's Ray Brewer has more on what prompted this warning.
Along New Road in New Market, the generators are humming as the power is still out. However, New Market Police have a warning for those homeowners after a resident gave them a call.
His neighbor found his generator at the end of the driveway along with a few gas cans that had been moved away from the house.
The sergeant says it appears someone was planning on stealing the generator.
It's disheartening that, you know, that there are people like that out there.
Jody Lamb is taking care of an elderly woman. She says their generator is a lifeline.
It allows for some lights. There is running water in certain areas of the house, but not all areas. But it is that it's hard. It is tough.
Sleeping at night in a cold house, that's very difficult.
George Merrill says he's able to get by with his generator, but would love to get his heat back on. However, he's not worried about it getting stolen.
Mine is chained to the wall, and there's no way anybody's gonna steal it.
It was a big surprise to come home from vacation at Myrtle Beach and see everything dark on the road still and wires hanging.
Greg Martin says they've been through this before. That's why they have the generator. He hadn't heard about the warning from the police department, but now he's planning on taking some precautions.
We'll probably pull it in at night, put it in the garage, and keep it safe.
And that was Ray Brew reporting. Another safety warning now, nearly 40 million fire extinguishers have been recalled because they may not work in an emergency. This recall impacts Kitty extinguishers made between 1973 and August 2017. The government says the extinguishers can become clogged and the nozzle can come off and pose an injury hazard. At least one death has been blamed on the extinguishers. If you have one of these, contact Kitty to ask for a replacement and for instructions and how to return recalled models. This weekend, tens of thousands of runners and more than 2 million spectators will pack the streets of New York City for the annual marathon. In light of Tuesday's attack, officials say they will have beefed up security measures in place. A Bedford woman will be running in the race on Sunday. Honey Weiss says despite the attack, she hasn't even considered backing out.
But as far as New York City Marathon, I'm there, you know. We can't let it stop us. Can't ever let us stop us from doing the things we love.
Honey says she has run the New York City Marathon after tragedy before. She completed the race less than 2 months after 9/11. And again, just a few months after the Boston Marathon bombing. Starting tonight at 5, New Hampshire has a new therapy option for disabled veterans. Who's picking up the bill? And the TSA is testing another new way to keep airport security moving more quickly. It could mean one less thing for you to keep track of. That does it for us here on the web. Have a great afternoon.